see why the dropping birth rate may not be such a good thing.
Learn about a new cell phone tower that will improve service in our area.
And details on the Black Creek Road that will remain open.
I'll listen more only on Channel 99.
Live from the Channel 99 studios in the Hazleton Area Career Center with Tiana Slattery,
Carlos Paredes,
Sports with Mark Brame, Wilson Mateo, and Leah Williams. Your 99 weather forecast with Christian Williams. This is your Channel 99 News.
Hi, I'm Carlos Paredes.
And I'm Tiana Slattery, and this is your Channel 99 News.
If you're one of the people who is scared of having an overcrowded planet, this story might be a bit bittersweet. Japan, the US, Germany, and Italy, what do all these countries have in common? A much lower birth rate than ever since the world underwent an economic decline. Now that the economy has some time to recover, these birth rates are still well below average. Studies show this is because families with less money aren't confident enough to have children. This affects much more than just population rates. Economists measure how well a country's economy is doing based on how many people leave the workforce, as opposed to how many people joined. If you haven't put the pieces together already, the new fear is that because such a low birth rate, in only a few years, there is a high risk of another economic decline, simply because of the fact there will be less people in general to join the workforce.
It's common knowledge that when your body loses temperature, your body slows down. Things like your metabolism and oxygen consumption go down, and you need less of these in order to survive. Now the less known facts, your body's entire metabolic activity slows down about 6% for every degree colder it gets. In theory, if you were too cold, your entire growth would stop, and you'd be frozen in time. Simple, right? Not quite. Hypothermia is a very dangerous and well-known problem for when your body is too cold. But then why can animals like ground squirrels survive hibernation in the winter, even in extremely cold temperatures? Scientists are working on unlocking to find out how we can take animal methods of survival and use them for our own. The hope is to make science fiction a reality and save many lives during surgery.
Had bad reception on your phone? Verizon is building a new cell tower that improves service. Hazel Township Zoning Hearing Board granted to a communications company for building a new cell tower that will lead to improve and ensure its networks won't get disrupted during periods of high use, according to testimony presented at Zoning Hearing Board on Monday. Verizon representatives, including attorney Rich Williams, civil engineer Joel Del Freitas, Jr., radio frequency engineer Peter Peterson, and land use consultant Jim Rogers. The board approved the request after hearing about 78 minutes worth of testimony from a team of Verizon experts and a handful of township residents who had mixed views on the cell tower.
Hilltop Road in the Black Creek Township Village of Rock Glen will stay open. The Black Creek Township Board of Supervisors on Tuesday voted unanimously to deny a request to vacate Hilltop Road made by two families who own property on each side of the unpaved roadway. The board heard testimony March 4th on a request made by the Kleckner family and the Ratzel family, asking the township to vacate the road and allow a gate across the roadway to set in place. Other residents of the community objected to the request, claiming that although the road is unpaved and unmaintained, many local residents use it as an alternate route out of a village or a shortcut to Nescopec. At the March 4th hearing, the Ratzel said without a gate across the roadway, the site invites illegal dumping and late-night parties, which create a nuisance. Other citizens noted the township receives state liquid fuels funding for Hilltop Road. Vacating the road would reduce the amount of state money the township receives for construction, reconstruction, maintaining, and repairing public roads. The March hearing concluded without a decision from the supervisors. Township Solicitor Donald Karpik recommended the board would postpone the action until the requesting families obtain a field survey and a legal description of the property.
Don't go away. When you come back, enjoy Leah Williams with sports.
Welcome to Channel 99, featuring the award-winning student-produced news now being broadcasted live over Service Electric Cable and YouTube every Tuesday through Friday at 2 p.m. We'll see you then, or check us out anytime at our website at www.bctv99.com. Welcome to Channel 99, featuring the award-winning student-produced news now being broadcasted live over Service Electric Cable and YouTube every Tuesday through Friday at 2 p.m. We'll see you then, or check us out anytime at our website at www.bctv99.com.
Welcome back to Channel 99 Sports. I'm Leah Williams. First, let's take a look at what the Cougars are up to. The Cougars fell short in last night's baseball game. The Bulldogs took this one against the Cougars 4-2. Their next game will be a makeup at Lake Lehman. The Cougars will play the Knights at 4:15. The Lady Cougars got their 12th straight victory in a row. The Lady Cougars singled in the second, top of the fifth, and in the sixth to get their 4 points in the 4-1 victory. Tonight, they will play the Comets at Crestwood at 4:15. The track and field teams will have their makeup game against the Pittston Patriots at 4:15 today. This will be their last home game before districts. And come support the graduating seniors from the volleyball team tonight. All seniors will be recognized in this last regular season home game. They will play the Coughlin Crusaders at 4:30. Well, that's all for your district sports. Now here is Mark and Wilson with Versus.
Hey. Welcome to Versus. How you doing, Wilson?
I'm doing all right. How you doing today?
Pretty good. All right, let's start off with the Brewers. You know, one of the hottest teams in baseball right now. A lot of people argue that the Detroit Tigers are one of the hottest teams, but the biggest surprise would have to be the Brewers because, you know, they haven't really come from a great standpoint of a baseball team. And, you know, the Detroit Tigers, they've been a strong playoff team the past couple of seasons. So, I mean, yeah, it's funny because you don't see the Brewers. That's how funny it is because you know I know the Brewers are not that good.
You'll be surprised.
But they won't carry the success that they have right now.
Yeah.
Just like the Yankees, they start off the year terrible.
It always happens. I don't know how. And you have this motivation. They think that you're gonna do good every year.
Yeah.
And then at the end, they don't even make the playoffs, and you're like.
Yeah, and then
it's a big surprise.
With the Brewers, they start off good and end up bad at the end of the season. They don't even make the playoffs. With the Yankees, they're subpar at the beginning of the year and near the end of the season. Going into the playoffs, they bang it out and they're good and they end up becoming one of the big threats in the playoffs.
Just like other teams, like they start very bad at the beginning. At the end of the season, you see that they get to the finals and you don't know how.
All right, next topic. Johnny Manziel or Jadeveon Clowney?
Johnny Manziel. Hands down, Johnny Manziel. Who are you going with?
You know, it's hard to say because if you're a team that's struggling defensively like the Cowboys or a team like that, you know, because the Cowboys are in mentioning with Manziel, they're also in mention with Jadeveon Clowney. And, you know, they are lacking a defensive end, even though they have one of the best DNs in all time in DeMarcus Ware. But, you know, I think I agree with you that Johnny Manziel will go first due to the fact that Texans do need a quarterback because Matt Schaub lost his career.
And I think Manziel will have more experience for some reason. Like, he'll come in more mature.
That's he's more electrifying.
Yeah,
he could bring that centerpiece offense that they need to bring in order to be a playoff-contending team again.
And I think, what I mean by that, in the fourth quarter, it comes down to it. Those type of players at the beginning of the season, they get nervous. I think he'll be that player that will actually take charge and do what he has to do.
All right, next topic. Now let's talk about NBA. Who do you think is the strongest team up to this point?
Up to this point? The Spurs.
Spurs,
why? Because every year they think they're down. They come in. They do it every year. This series, they're 2-0 up. I think they're going to sweep them. And if you put them in the spot that you put them last year with the sixth game, they will win.
Yeah.
They will win. And I believe that's the drive this season.
And there's so much controversy in last year's finals game, but that's last year. No worries about this year. But if I had to say somebody, it would be the Clippers. You know, they have that heat and that fire of that anger that they had with their owner, and they're going to bring that fire and just take it to the playoffs. And, I mean, I know they're tied in their series after their loss. But, you know, I think the Clippers are going to be in it, and who knows? We got to see.
I mean, if they get past the Thunders, then it's because the Thunders are just, they're fire, same as the Clippers. Mm. it's big. You have an MVP that they won. You have all these good players that they should do really good.
All right, well, that's all we have for you. I'm Mark Brame.
I'm Wilson Mateo.
See ya.
Welcome to Channel 99, featuring the award-winning student-produced news now being broadcasted live over Service Electric Cable and YouTube every Tuesday through Friday at 2 p.m. We'll see you then, or check us out anytime at our website at www.bctv99.com.
You're tuned into BCTV, the only publicly televised and high school student-run channel in the entire country. Network. We're now streaming live from YouTube every Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday at 2 p.m. You can check us out at youtube.com/99BCTV.
Welcome to Channel 99, featuring the award-winning student-produced news now being broadcasted live over Service Electric Cable and YouTube every Tuesday through Friday at 2 p.m. We'll see you then, or check us out anytime at our website at www.bctv99.com.
Welcome back to your Channel 99 News. I'm Christian Williams here with your weather forecast. Do you like marshmallows? Well, we don't have marshmallows, but we do have something similar. Clouds, which you'll be seeing a lot of this week. The high for today is 67 degrees, but it feels like it's 63. Not much of a difference, but hey, it's better than the low of 55 tonight, especially when you mix in thunderstorms throughout the night. But you better get used to the ugly weather, because the next few days will be scattered with rain and thunderstorms. On the bright side, there will be sunshine on Sunday. Literally, it's the only sunny day for the next few days. And what better day than Sunday, am I right? Anyway, the temperatures will be in the upper 60s and 70s, reaching up to almost 80 degrees. And that's with all of the thunderstorms going on. And with all the rain, we're lucky the temps are going to drop to around 50 degrees this weekend. And if you're wondering when this stream of bad weather will come to an end, don't get your hopes up, because it looks as cloudy as far as next weekend. But that's all for your Channel 99 weather. Stay clear of driving during the thunderstorms and stay tuned. Those marshmallows will come soon enough.
Before we leave, here's a special interview with Mary Vic Perez.
We are here today with Victor Perez, president of the Dominican House of Hazleton. So, Mr. Victor Perez, how are you today?
How you doing, Mary Vic Perez?
Well, I understand that the Dominican House is a nonprofit organization, but what exactly does it do for our community?
The Dominican House is a nonprofit organization founded in August 20, 2005 in Hazleton, Pennsylvania. Some group of people from the Dominican community create this organization with intention to promote the Hispanic culture in Hazleton, Pennsylvania. So the founder of the Dominican House, the first president, was Manuel Saldana. He was a person with a group of people that created this organization. And this is not just an organization for Dominicans people. Is an organization open to everybody, open for the Hispanic community.
Yes.
This is the house of the Hispanic community, but it's open to everybody in all the for all the community, because right now we are giving some service to that everybody or anyone can receive the service for the Dominica House.
They can benefit from it.
Yes, they can benefit anyone.
Perfect. Now, I am also aware that the Dominican House as a whole has won many awards and recognitions, such as this one we have here. Could you explain that to us in a little bit further details?
The Dominican House received a lot of recognition from different organizations. This one is the last one that we received from the Consulate of the Dominican Republic.
Okay.
This is the logo or the emblem of the Dominican Republic. So that means the Dominican House represents the Dominican's organization in Hazleton, Pennsylvania, according with the government of the Dominican Republic.
Okay.
That's why we bring it here, because somebody was coming that we do not represent the Dominicans, or we do not represent the people involved with the Dominican Republic or something like that. So this recognition coming from the Dominican government, mm-hmm. and we got another recognition from the Congress mm-hmm. of the Dominican Republic when they recognize that we are the organization who represent the Dominicans in Hazleton, Pennsylvania. We are the only one organization who represent the Dominicans in Hazleton organization, authorized from the government of the Dominican Republic and the Congress of the Dominican Republic.
Perfect.
We have we receive other awards from the governor of the Pennsylvania, state of Pennsylvania, Mr. Tom Corbett. We receive another award from the mayor of the city of Hazleton. We receive another award from the this institution, Career Center.
Oh, from the
we receive
Center.
Another award from the immigration. I forgot the name.
No problem.
It's another organization that worked with the immigrants in Hazleton.
Okay.
And, we are receiving a lot of awards, mm-hmm. but that's not exactly what the Dominican House is looking for. We are not looking for that award. We are looking for the award that the people, the Hispanic community, concentrate in the correct integration in this community, and we can work together in the whole community. We believe that's the best award that we can receive, because our mission is to work together with the correct and real integration with this community of Hazleton. We believe that one hand in this community can wash the other hand, but together, both hands can wash the face of this community. That's what we believe.
Perfect. And also, before we wrap it up, you were what everyone was talking about in mid-February. Now, what was exactly the purpose for your petition for flying the Dominican flag?
That was a very interesting situation.
It was.
Because it's the first time in my whole life that I received something like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because you are my daughter, that I'm working with that community with a long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
I got more than 40 years working with the community, community service. But no one know about that. No one know exactly that we come, for example, from New Jersey State. We were living in New Jersey, and we work with the community service, giving community service in that state. And I come in from New Jersey, and I was a judge from the Board of Election of the Dominican Republic in that state. So I am a person that received got authority in New Jersey, and we come to Hazleton, Pennsylvania, looking for a better quality of life and more quiet place to live. But unfortunately, we found a problem.
Mm-hmm.
We found a lot of situation with a controversy of the ordinance from the mayor in 2006. We were not living in Hazleton in that way, but that problem we found it. And then when we integrate in the Dominican House, we receive another situation. The community was divided for people who tried to use our community the Dominican people that come from Dominican Republic divided because one purpose. In Hazleton, we found people that they are using some part of the community to receive some money, to receive some benefits. And we are concerned about that. So that's why we are trying to promote the correct culture of our people, the people that we know. Mm-hmm. Because you cannot talk about the community you don't know. Mm-hmm. So some people that they don't know the community of Dominican Republic, they talk about our community, that they are just people that are drug dealers or people mm-hmm. involved in crime and something like that. We all the time say that we got some apples in a table. And you can find one apple that is not a good apple. But that's not mean that the rest of the apples are bad
are
apples.
Are spoiled, that they're bad.
That's well. Why we yes. are concerned, we were concerned about what's going on. So then we are trying to give something positive to the people that is working every morning, every afternoon, every night in this city of Hazleton, mm-hmm. giving the best of his life for this community. That's why in 2013, we were motivated to send a letter to the mayor of this city of Hazleton requesting a petition to permit that in this February 27, that's the day of independence of the Dominican Republic, mm-hmm. to permit to raise the flag of the Dominican Republic. That's a culture. That's a tradition in the whole of the United States of America. You can find that tradition in city in Hazleton, in Pennsylvania, like Harrisburg. You can find the same tradition in Scranton. You can find the same tradition in Philadelphia, Reading, Lancaster, and so on, and so on, and so on. But the same thing happened in New Jersey. The whole state of New Jersey do that tradition. New York, Florida, Alaska, the different state in the United States of America. But we found a different situation here. In 2013, when we sent a letter to the mayor, he sent to us nothing about that petition. So he ignored us. And then in 2014, sorry, that was in 2013. And then in this year, 2014, we sent again the same petition mm-hmm. with a different that we send a copy of each one of the medias mm-hmm. around Pennsylvania and around some different state. That's create a situation because the city of Hazleton have to answer to us about that petition. That's mm-hmm. why it was a controversy.
Okay.
Because we know, according with the standard speaking newspaper, that the city of Hazleton permit to raise the flag mm-hmm. to another country that we respect. They raise the flag of the Irish, and then we know that they got the same right to permit to raise the flag. Not just the Irish. They have the same right to permit to raise the flag of the Italians or the Mexican or the
correct.
Cuban, any other country in each one of the days that they got Independence Day, or they celebrate that day. So that's why we request that permission for that day. We do not request to put it down the flag of the United States of America because I am a U.S. citizen and I am proud to be a U.S. citizen. Mm-hmm. And I am proud because I got the double nationality, U.S. citizen and Dominican citizen. So we request to raise the flag that day together with the flag of the United States of America. That's the tradition. We know the procedure. We never try to fur to the flag of the United States of America. A lot of people was coming that we try to we respect the United States of America flag, and that was not our intention. The people was confused because a lot of people was coming in different ways, bad things about that intention. The intention was to give us something positive to our community, the Dominican people that is proud to work here, that is proud to give us something positive to this city and this community, and that's why we request that. It's a tradition. And then, for example, in Dominican Republic, the 4th of July, the that the whole country celebrate the independence of the Dominican, the United States of America. Mm-hmm. So that's why it's a tradition between one country and another. But what the mayor say, the mayor of the Hazleton city say, no, there is a law in the state of Pennsylvania that do not permit to raise another flag than the United States of America. With all respect, we don't have to agree with that opinion, or if they permit that they raise a flag of the Irish flag, and they raise the flag of the Italian flag, mm-hmm. Italy flag, why they don't want to permit that raise a flag of the Dominican Republic? It's the same rights. This is an equal opportunity for everybody. This is a free country. We have to work together for everybody. But the point is that we have to work in front of that law. If that law says that in the state of Pennsylvania, why cities like Allentown, Harrisburg, the capital city, Philadelphia, Scranton, Lancaster, Reading, they permit to raise the flag of other countries? So they are in violation of that law. We are concerned about that. So we need an investigation about that. That's why we request to the Pennsylvania Human Relations Commission to investigate what's going on with this, because this is their right. We got the right to request something that we are concerned. So sometimes the people understand or misunderstand that we are trying to create a controversy or creating problem or trouble in this city. That's not the truth. You got the right to request the answers from the law, according with the law and according with the Constitution of the United States of America. I support the Constitution, I support the law of the United States of America, and I support the flag of the United States of America. But if something is in controversy with the Constitution and the law, I am a U.S. citizen, and we got a lot of U.S. citizen members of the Dominican House that request the permission from the Human Relations Commission to conduct an investigation about exactly what's going on. And finally, I want to say something regarding that, something that some group that they say that they represent the Latinos community regarding us. They say that we have to live from here because we create this controversy regarding the Dominican flag. Never in the United States of America, one group that they say that they represent the Latinos community never go in the wrong way, because they are Dominican origin, and this is the first time that I saw one person that deny his flag when they are coming from by birth, and they try to create a controversy because we are not creating a controversy. And that's why that's the people that the zone authority here try to protect. The people that go against his origin, they go against his flags or that they are coming from, and they are go against what his people, his family believe. I know that his grandfathers, his grandparents are, if they are dead right now, they are thinking in negative way about what they said that day in the conference, press conference, that they, when they said something wrong regarding the Dominican House and regarding myself and my family. They say something negative regarding us, and they say that we have to get back to New Jersey or something like that because somebody removed us from New Jersey. They doesn't know about us, and they doesn't know that I am a person and I was an authority in New Jersey. I never, and my family never been involved in anything negative in the United States of America. And they doesn't know that I am a U.S. citizen. My whole family are U.S. citizens. My father is a U.S. citizen. My grandparents are U.S. citizens. And my grand-grandfather coming from England. They doesn't know nothing about us. They talk in public, giving wrong information to the community. And the community has to understand that they have to listen both sides of this story to receive the opportunity to, like Jesus Christ said, believe in the truth. And we are giving the truth. We are not people to try to accommodate the truth or try to create controversy. The controversy about the Dominican flags was created because the mayor decided to do that in that way. If you can find around the United States of America, the whole United States of America permit that other flag can raise in the Independence Day.
All right. Well, it was a pleasure having you, Victor. And on behalf of Channel 99, we want to thank you for your help, not only towards the Hispanic community, but really the community as a whole. It was a great pleasure having you.
Thank you for the opportunity, Mary Vic Perez. I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
I am proud of the Career Center to give it to you the opportunity, because I know what you are trying to do.
Thank you.
I know you will be good.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mary Vic Perez, back to you guys.